Setting up the 1.5 and 2-inch flow meters is easy, but there are some things you need to be aware of to get the best possible performance. In this video, we'll set up a few parameters so you can see how to navigate the parameter menus, and we'll share some installation tips to help ensure you get the best possible results with these 1.5-inch and 2-inch flow meters. In the next video, we'll walk through all of the parameters and offer some tips on how and when to use them. To configure the flow meter, go to the menu chapter of the user manual. This first chart just says pressing the up and down arrows will cycle the meter through the various display options from gallons per minute to gallons per hour to total gallons and fluid temperature. And that pressing the enter button from any of the displays will drop you into the parameter setting menu. All of these will fall back to the default display you select after 15 seconds of no button presses. By the way, I'm using the 1001 flow meter in this example. The parameter chart for the 1002 uses the same basic flow, but some of the options are different because it has two analog outputs, where the 1001 has one analog and a configurable digital output. Once you've seen how this one works, you'll be able to easily navigate the other one. Let's do an example so you can get a feel for how parameters are set on this flow meter. One of the cool things you can do with these larger flow meters is you can simulate the flow. Press enter to drop into the parameters, and then arrow down to the EF menu, that's the extended function menu. Press enter to drop into that menu, and then scroll down to the sim menu and press enter to drop into that. To set the simulated flow rate, press enter to select it, and then hold down the arrow button until it stops blinking, just a second or two. Now scroll to the flow rate we want and press enter to accept it. Then down arrow to the temperature simulation, enter to accept that, hold down the arrow key until it stops blinking and change the temperature. Press enter to accept that. Arrow down again to the simulation time or duration, this is how long the simulation is going to last. Enter into that parameter, hold down the arrow key to change that, and enter to accept the change. Finally, down arrow one more time to the enable, enter to accept that, turn it on, and accept that. Now if we go back to the main menu, we can see the gallons per minute, the gallons per hour, the number we actually set, the total gallons adding up, and a temperature that was set for the simulation. Notice that the word sim pops up every now and then to remind us this is a simulation. All of the parameters are set the exact same way. Enter to drop into a menu or a setting, and arrows to scroll or change. There are a couple other things you need to be aware of before using this flow meter. First, you can specify what you want the analog output to do in case of an error. It can go to a high value, a low value, or just output the measured value. The main thing to be aware of here is you need to make sure your equipment can handle the currents and voltages outside of the normal 4 to 20 milliamp or 0 to 10 volt range before using these options. The orientation of the flow meter is very important. There are a bunch of diagrams in the user manual like this that show you the proper orientation, but the bottom line is you want to install the flow meter so that it never gets any air bubbles stuck in it. You want a solid stream of liquid to get accurate results. Flow direction is very important. There's an arrow etched on the side of the unit. The display will show negative flow if you get it backwards, but the outputs won't do what you expect. On these 1.5-inch and 2-inch units, you can reverse the flow in a menu setting, and they even come with a little arrow sticker you can put over the etched arrow on the housing. You can mount the unit upside down, as long as the flow is in the right direction, and there's even a parameter you can set to invert the display to make it easier to read. You can lock out unintentional button presses by holding the up and down arrows for 10 seconds. To get it back, just hold the same buttons for another 10 seconds. This will allow folks to look at all of the menus and parameters, they just won't be able to change anything while it's locked out. This is a Class 3 device, so the power supply doesn't have to be grounded. But the flow meter itself does need to be grounded. So if you put this in line in a PVC pipe system, for example, be sure to run a ground wire from the unit. Automation Direct has a convenient ground clamp for this if you need it. Well, that ought to be enough to get you started with the 1.5-inch and 2-inch versions of this magnetic inductive flow meter from Automation Direct. Chapter 8 of the user manual lists all of the parameters and even has little examples to show how to set up each one. You can jump straight to that to get going right now, or if you want to take a quick walkthrough of all the parameters along with some hints on how to use them, check out the next video. If you have any questions, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct support staff there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis.